Coming up on NTC News, Illinois is changing the minimum wage. We take a look at how it could affect you.
This while grad students are picketing and protesting for higher wages.
And new scholarships to honor the NIU students who lost their lives in an Aurora shooting. We'll have that story.
NTC News starts now.
You're watching NTC News, DeKalb County's only television news source. On the campus of Northern Illinois University and from the Northern Television Center, this is NTC News Tonight.
Hello, I'm Issa Sanchez.
And I'm Crystal Termini. It's Thursday, April 25th. Thanks for joining us. If you're a student making minimum wage, you might be excited to know that you might be getting a raise. But that's not necessarily good news for everyone. NTC reporter Victor Oweye has more on the state's minimum wage increase.
Governor J.B. Pritzker has signed a law to raise the minimum wage in Illinois to $15 by 2025. The governor says this increase is in order to better the lives of the people in Illinois.
If you live in this state and put in a hard day's work, you should be able to afford to put a roof over your head and food on the table.
A local DeKalb store owner believes this increase is a positive decision.
Well, I think it's a more livable wage than what it is now, and I think that people need it. They need the money.
With multiple small businesses in the DeKalb area, an employee thinks there could be some possible ramifications.
There's going to definitely be a lot of issues for the small business owners just because, if the minimum wage is $15, you know, what are they going to pay their higher up employees? Can they afford that? Can they cope with that? You know, especially these smaller businesses that don't have the same intake every day that, you know, some of the larger stores do.
She also thinks this increase will change the way companies choose their employees in the future.
I definitely think that small business owners are going to be looking for more qualified individuals. And I just mean that in the sense that, you know, I think we're going to get to a certain point in time where everybody's going to need a degree because it's going to be that much harder to get a job.
Since many students on NIU's campus are subject to minimum wage jobs, we asked them what they think about this possible change.
Because, like, some people pay for their tuition and also some people live off campus, so they can contribute that to rent or food or whatever else they have to pay for.
But being like a CA, we only work 2 hours a week. We get paid for our 2 hours. And only making 10, basically it's only $20 a week, so making it, at least raising it to 30 is a little bit better.
Going the way like the economy works is also going to mean a lot of rises in prices and things like that, gas, any taxes, anything like that, all that's going to go up just because minimum wage goes up. So
for NTC News, I'm Victor Oweye.
The process to make the change is beginning this summer, but as Victor mentioned, it should be in full effect by the year 2025.
College of Business held an event in honor of two NIU students who lost their lives in an Aurora shooting. Senior Trevor Wayner and alumnus Clayton Parks were among the five people killed in a shooting that occurred in Aurora in February. The Golden Heart Celebration took place on what would have been Wayner's golden birthday. Students from Wayner's Management 460 class put together a scholarship to honor them both. The two students who are chosen to receive the scholarship will be announced at the Department of Management Award Banquet later today.
Community college representatives and university leaders, including Lisa Freeman, have joined together to create a new equity plan. Its goal is to close graduation gaps for students of color, first-generation students, and low-income students. The Illinois Equity and Attainment Initiative created the plan. The group reports 33% of African American students complete a bachelor's degree in 6 years. Meanwhile, 49% of Latinos are earning degrees. 37% of low-income students graduate in 6 years compared to 75% of wealthier students. The group sent out a survey to the campus community to learn more about areas of improvement. The survey found the program needs a clearer definition of what equity means to NIU.
Diversity is a hot topic here at NIU as a new event has been approved for the fall. According to the Northern Star, the NIU Diversity Ball will be held in the Duke Ellington Ballroom in the Home Student Center. The ball's purpose is to promote alliance between student bodies and celebrate cultural variety and unity. The event was brought to life after an electrical engineering major noticed several misconceptions of diversity on campus.
If you ever had a graduate student teaching your class, you might not know that they may be getting paid less than teachers. That's what has graduate students at Loyola University walking a picket line and even getting arrested. WGN is covering the story, and this is their report.
I refuse to have my voice silenced.
Graduate student workers at Loyola University in Chicago.
I refuse to let this just be a Loyola for them. It's time that it's a Loyola for us.
Are protesting the school's administration.
We work, we teach, now practice what you preach.
And mounting a campaign to improve their status on campus.
I refuse to be the cheap labor that keeps tuition flowing into this university.
These graduate students are attempting to highlight what they say is a major problem in higher education. Increasing tuition coupled with limited compensation they get in exchange for their work as teaching assistants. But the school says it will not recognize them as a union because it sees them as students, not employees.
We give them the best possible package that Loyola can afford.
Thomas Regan, the dean of the Loyola University Graduate School, says there will not be negotiations with graduate student workers.
We only negotiate with people who are workers, and in this definition, they are students through and through.
I don't really understand what his issue is with recognizing that we're both.
31-year-old Jean Clifford is working toward her PhD in philosophy. During the course of her studies, she's racked up an enormous amount of debt.
I have over $130,000 in debt.
The students attempted to block the sidewalk and public entrance of the university's administrative offices. And were warned by Chicago police before being taken away in handcuffs. They left the demonstration with a demand.
Enough is enough. If Loyola administrators have not agreed to work toward a fair contract by April 24th, we are prepared to walk out for our students and for ourselves.
We would hope that that would not happen because it harms our undergraduates, and our mission here is to all of our students.
And students kept their promises as they held a walkout followed by a rally yesterday. That again was a report from WGN. Time now for a quick check of the weather. It is so nice and sunny outside, but will it stay for good?
Claudia Olek is outside telling us what to expect. Claudia?
Thanks, guys. Well, conditions are very mild and beautiful right now for this time of year. However, they will change pretty soon into our weekend. We'll see some showers roll through our area into tonight. A spike in temperatures coming into your weekend, as well as more rain for that Tux Championship on Saturday. I'll have more on the full update later in the show.
After the break, pulling their weight, we'll tell you about a Greek life tradition that's in full swing.
And if you're into Dragon Ball Z and Sailor Moon, then chances are you know where you were on Saturday and you weren't alone. More on the anime convention when we come back.
After the break, pulling their weight, we'll tell you about a Greek life tradition that's in full swing.
And if you're into Dragon Ball Z and Sailor Moon, then chances are we know where you were on Saturday and you weren't alone. More on the anime convention when we come back.
There's a familiar name vying for the top job at the White House.
NTC reporter Evan Johnson has more on that in this week's Political Pit Stop. Evan?
There is a lot happening in politics, so let's jump right in. There is a new candidate entering the crowded Democratic race. After months of consideration, the former Vice President, Joe Biden, announced earlier this morning that he would be entering the 2020 presidential race. In his campaign announcement video, Biden publicly displayed his disagreement with Trump's handling of crucial situations. Biden says that this race is a battle for the soul of this nation. In response, President Trump referred to Biden as Sleepy Joe in a tweet. President Trump is still under fire, but he's determined to push back. He's suing his former accounting firm and the House Oversight Committee chairman over subpoenas to disclose his financial records. Democrats are seeking to get those along with the full Mueller report on the Russian investigation. President Trump says he is fighting all the subpoenas. A new member of Trump's cabinet is facing backlash from the media. According to the New York Times, the current White House chief of staff tried to protect the president from hearing about or dealing with anything related to the alleged Russian involvement in the 2016 presidential election. Mick Mulvaney responded to the report yesterday by saying that he doesn't recall anything along those lines happening in any meeting. Mulvaney told the media that the Trump administration will not tolerate foreign interference in their elections. And that's it for this week's segment. Now back to our crew at the desk.
Thanks, Evan. Now, Crystal, do you like technology?
Why do you ask?
Because it's time for this week's Tech Talk, my favorite part.
Same.
It's a bird, it's a plane, it's a drone. Google-owned company Wing Aviation just got government approval to work as an airline. So what exactly does this mean? Well, you may soon get food and small items delivered to you with a drone. The company says it plans to begin deliveries in two rural communities in Virginia. So pretty cool stuff there. And now, how much would you pay for a TV? How much, Crystal?
Like $100.
Well, Sony announced the pricing for their new TV models, and there is one that is quite interesting. It is the Sony Z9G, which costs a whopping $70,000.
It's a little out of my price range.
So why is it so much? Well, it is a 98-inch 8K LCD TV. And if you have the money, the TV will be available in June. And now, last week I talked about the Samsung Galaxy Fold pre-orders selling out. You know, it was very popular. Well, after early reviewers had issues with their screens, the tech company announced that they will actually delay the launch of the new phone. Samsung says that they will investigate this issue and they will not release the phone until it is resolved. And Tugs is an annual NIU tradition that had students stepping up and challenging each other all week, and tonight is a very big night.
NTC reporter Dejanaria Ferguson had the chance to sit down with a reporter who was covering Tugs and tells us more about this competition. Deja?
Thanks, guys. I'm here with Maddie Barrett, who is a reporter for the Northern Star and Top Shelf Sports. How are you today?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm good. Thanks for asking. The first question I would like to ask, can you tell me about the importance of Tugs?
Yeah, so it's the 36th annual competition for them. So it's been going on for quite some time, and it really helps to bring everyone together and the brotherhood of all of the fraternities together.
Tugs is benefiting Camp Cansom this year, and I heard that you are the co-founder of that. Can you tell me a little bit more about the organization?
Yeah, so the organization actually benefits kids whose parents have cancer. They hold a week-long camp for them in the summer, and it's free of charge for everyone.
Where does the money go towards to after the competition?
So the Tugs is kind of like a fundraising aspect for them. They really want to raise money to send a kid to camp, and it's $500 to send each kid to camp. So it's really important that they raise that money so that the parents don't have to pay.
Mm-hmm. How long does Tugs typically last?
So this year it's from Monday till Saturday with a break on Friday.
Mm-hmm. What is this week's schedule looking like for Tugs?
So today there's a competition at 3:30, Sigma Nu versus Phi Sigma Kappa at 3:30, and then at 5 o'clock, there's Phi Kappa Psi versus Phi Kappa Theta. Friday, they have a day off, and then Saturday, there's competitions from 9:30 in the morning until 2 p.m. when their championship round is.
Where would Tugs take place this year?
So it's been taking place at University Plaza, behind University Plaza, and hopefully it doesn't rain.
Thank you so much, Maddie, for coming to talk to me. Back to Crystal and Isai.
Well, the sun is finally out, and it feels amazing outside to watch the Tugs competition. Have you gone and seen the Tugs competition?
I haven't, actually. I've been busy with a whole bunch of other things.
No,
you know,
you school. You can take a break. It's a break.
School
break.
Is school, you know? I never have time.
You can make time.
Oh, well, my question is this cold weather actually going to stay here, you know? I really don't want this cold weather to come back. I want it
either.
To stay warm.
Yes.
And well, Claudia Olek has more info on that. Claudia?
Well, guys, it looks like today will be the last day to watch tugs in sunshine. It looks like the rain today is going to dodge our area. For today, those temperatures right now are at upper 60s at 66 degrees there. And if we take a look at what's going on outside, we can see a system off to our south, even one further south that's producing severe weather. And the one to our north, we might catch the tail end of that later tonight. But for tugs today, you will be in the clear. Looking temperature wise, we're pretty fair, so it will stay warm into today and tomorrow. And boy, look at those temperatures down south. I sure wish we were talking about those. But for today, it looks like that high is 70 degrees there. So temperatures will fall into the 40s at 46 degrees there. But for tonight, the chance of precipitation is 90% there. So rain will start a little at dinner time, about 7, 8 o'clock. But for tomorrow, the end of your week, nothing but sunshine. A little bit windy, though. Those winds will be out of the northwest at 20 miles an hour. And it'll still stay warm with temperatures in the 60s at 61 degrees. For the Tugs Championship, however, I hate to say it, but it's going to be a complete different story. We're talking rain all throughout the day, starting in the morning and continuing into the night. And look at those temperatures, 44 degrees. I don't think we've seen those temperatures for about a week or so, and the lows will dip into the 20s at 27 degrees. And you might have seen snow on that screen, and that is where the rain might transition into snow into the overnight hours, for it will get so cold. But for the end of your weekend, back to sunshine, temperatures increase just a little bit at 50 degrees there. And into your work week, we can see chances of rain for almost every day, but you could see an increase in temperatures, 54 on Monday, 56 on Tuesday, and we're welcoming May with 60s at 61 on Wednesday. That's it for weather. Back to you.
Every year, the Anime Association has an event where people can dress up as their favorite characters and get some pretty cool gear. I had the chance to get an inside look into this one-of-a-kind convention.
No, Halloween didn't come early this year. This is KuroshiCon, a free anime convention held every year at NIU. Hosted by the NIU Anime Association, the goal is to bring people together and have fun.
This small college community is a perfect setting for college kids and the public and the community to have a place that they can celebrate that they love anime and pop culture and all sorts of different cool genres, and that's what KuroshiCon is about.
So what is there to do at KuroshiCon? Well, there's a traditional game room where people can play their favorite board or card games. The other big attraction is a vendor hall with 80 vendors selling merchandise and unique art. And finally, a video game room. This convention may be a lot of work, but one Anime Association member still has a blast.
My first time it was actually, kind of overwhelming. But, after a while, it's pretty fun to work. Even though you're working it doesn't really seem like you're working it, because it is a convention. So it's a whole bunch of fun.
One thing you'll notice are all the people cosplaying as their favorite anime, movie, or video game characters. But some care more about its affordable cost.
I don't really make that much money in my job now, but the fact that it's a free con, me and my boyfriend, we just come here and we just hang out and have a good time.
With over 750 attendees, it's no wonder why the secretary of the Anime Association believes this convention can become something big.
We hope to be back again next year and be even bigger, because we definitely had way more people that have signed up this year than probably in the last year or two. So I'm really looking forward to how much it can expand, and we're hoping to get a lot more community involvement next year.
And if you love everything I just mentioned, the Anime Association meets every Tuesday and Thursday from 6 to 9.
The NFL draft begins tonight, and a pair of former NFL football players are expecting to hear their names called up. We'll tell you who they are and where they're expected to be drafted.
And the Force was with them as hundreds of people went to the city to celebrate everything Star Wars. We were there, and we will have more on that story after this break.
You made this vacation happen, cleverly merging promotions,
double points with every purchase,
and cross-referencing travel sites. Aloha! If you can ace your vacation, you can do it for retirement. Get on track with tips at aceyourretirement.org.
Hey,
listen, I realize that I'm not perfect, but it all really started to change because you judge me for having a problem. No one is going to know that I need help. I need help. I know that no one is going to judge me for having a problem. I realize that I'm not perfect, but it all really started to change because you listen.
NIU football has closed shop for the spring, but the excitement surrounding Thomas Hammock's first year as head coach will carry into the summer.
NTC sportscaster Kobe Price will update you on the Husky Bowl and all the latest in Husky athletics. Kobe?
Thanks, Crystal and Isai. The football team kicked off a big week in the NIU Athletics World last weekend as nearly 500 people gathered in Husky Stadium for NIU's penultimate spring practice, the Husky Bowl. The exhibition features 7-on-7 drills and situational 11-on-11 scrimmages with live contact. The offense showed some new wrinkles under head coach Hammock, with quarterbacks Marcus Childers and Anthony Thompson having impressive performances, including a 60-yard touchdown pass from Childers in the 7-on-7 drills and two TD passes from Thompson.
It was good to see the offense make some plays, have some sustained drives down the field. That's something that we wanted to cut. The other day, the defense got after us pretty good, and I think our offense responded today with a solid performance.
Sticking with the gridiron, the 2019 NFL Draft begins tonight, and a couple former Huskies are expected to hear their names called from the podium. Defensive end Sutton Smith is projected to be selected in the later rounds of the draft. The two-time Mid-American Conference Defensive Player of the Year is expected to make an NFL roster due to his skill set and tenacity. While various mock drafts have offensive lineman Max Sharpie being taken in the middle rounds and projects to be an NFL starter. Good luck, fellas. NIU Athletic Director Sean Fraser was awarded the 2019 Deacon Davis Diversity Award. The award was presented on April 18th at PCSM's annual Diversity and Inclusion Luncheon. The award recognizes significant contributions made to the improvement of the status of minorities at NIU. In 2014, Fraser served as the co-chair of the campus's Diversity and Inclusion Task Force. It led to the hiring of NIU's first chief diversity officer. Men's basketball will see some new faces next season. Top assistant coach John Borovich is expected to leave the cornfields behind and head for the big city. According to the Chicago Tribune, Borovich is close to finalizing a deal to be hired by Northwestern's men's basketball. He would fill a void on Chris Collison's staff just 2 years after a second-round NCAA tournament appearance. Borovich, who has been under head coach Mount Montgomery's watch since 2011, played collegiate basketball at Central Michigan University and was an asset for recruiting and was a big part of the Huskies' Cinderella run in this year's MAC tournament. The men's tennis team fell short to the Western Michigan Broncos in the MAC championships on Sunday. After coming back from a 3-0 deficit and tying the set at 3 apiece, NIU fell to the Broncos in a third set tiebreaker. The Huskies received recognition for the success. Senior Eric Marbach earned first-team All-MAC honors, while junior Boris Schwager-Muzar was named to the All-MAC second team. The women's golf team closed out its season on a high note, taking third place in the MAC championship tournament. Freshman Ara Coe tied for fifth in a new career-high finish, while senior Braille Ward tied for ninth place in her final collegiate tournament. The bronze finish is the program's third straight top three finish in the conference. The men's golf team wrapped up their regular season finishing 14th out of 15 teams at the Robert Kepler Intercollegiate Tournament in Columbus, Ohio. Senior Paul Schlim finished a team-high 27th, hitting 6 over par. The Huskies now head to Aurora, Ohio Friday to start the MAC championships, hoping to win their first title since 1985. A new rivalry will be born tomorrow night when the men's soccer team faces DeKalb County United of UPSL. The semi-pro team opens their season at NIU Soccer and Track and Field Complex with an exhibition, with the collegiate team wrapping up their spring practices. Admission for NIU students is free and kickoff is scheduled for 7 p.m. Now, the baseball team is reeling right now after losing its third straight game Tuesday against Illinois State. NIU remains above 500 in both conference play and home games, but we'll head for Oxford, Ohio to take on the Miami Redhawks in a three-game MAC series starting tomorrow at 3 p.m. And the softball team continues to roll through MAC play. The Huskies have won 7 of their last 9 contests after picking up a pair of victories over Central Michigan over the weekend. Senior infielder was named to the MAC player Tuesday after NIU won 4 of its 5 games last week. Schmidt became the third Husky to earn the MAC's weekly honor this season. She batted .563 with 9 hits and recorded a team-high 9 RBIs. The Huskies will return to action Tuesday, 3 p.m. in a doubleheader against Valparaiso University. That's all for NTC Sports, and as always, go Huskies. Crystal, Isai, back to you at the desk.
There's a new Star Wars movie making its debut in December, and that has lots of fans dusting off their lightsabers. NTC reporter Victor Carranza headed to Chicago for the 13th Star Wars Celebration.
An empire has invaded Chicago. And no, I'm not talking about this empire. I'm talking about the legion of Star Wars fans who took over McCormick Place for the 13th Star Wars Celebration. The show kicked off with a sneak peek of the highly anticipated movie. For 4 days, people from all over the world came to celebrate one thing, Star Wars. One fan even took her passion and made it a job, becoming the first female stormtrooper in franchise history. She says being in the movies is very different from watching them.
Everyone knows that they are part of something special. Like, it's not like a regular film set. Like, there's an energy, like, and a buzz that comes from being on the Star Wars set. The crew, the cast, the extras, everyone has that, and you can tell because people will just be looking around and like, oh my god, I'm on the Star Wars set.
With over thousands in attendance, fans took this opportunity to cosplay as their favorite characters. This is a way of life for some convention goers, and for one Star Wars fan, they can't remember a life before a galaxy far, far away.
Star Wars means like everything to me. I grew up with it. I literally can't remember a day in my life where there wasn't Star Wars.
For NTC News, I'm Victor Carranza.
Not Star Wars, then maybe Avengers is what has you excited for the weekend. Tonight is the night Marvel fans have been waiting for. Avengers Endgame premieres in theaters across the nation. With the movie expected to beat Avatar's opening numbers, it's safe to say that this movie will be a summer hit. And keep in mind, tickets have already been sold out for weeks. Are you watching the movie?
Oh yes, I'm going right after class tonight.
Crazy.
I know. NTC News is produced and directed by students here at Northern Illinois University.
Thanks for watching, everyone. Have a good day.